In the news tonight, woman killed, body burnt, mentally unstable construction worker arrested, and white boy's auto spears destroyed by fire. A mentally unstable construction worker is now in police custody following the murder of a woman who he was working for. That is Shannon Omomodel Mohammed. She was reportedly killed by the suspect, who then burnt the remains at her construction site, which he was working on. The police was alerted to the burnt body at Parika East Bank Essequibo by an anonymous caller. When ranks got to the scene, they observed what appeared to be burnt skull and torso lying among debris at the front of the incomplete flat concrete structure. Further, the police are reporting that a sledgehammer and a crowbar were found near the burnt remains. Further information received that at approximately 9 hours yesterday morning, the 29-year-old Mohammed of Parika visited the location and went down to the back of the yard where a home is currently being constructed by the suspect, whose only name was given as Rodwell. Family members told police investigators that during the day they tried contacting her, but all calls went unanswered and her whereabouts were unknown. Last night, family members decided to venture down to the back of the yard to Mohammed's construction site, where they observed a fire. They also saw Rodwell walking away, heading towards the end of the yard, disappearing in the darkness. Family members used buckets of water from a nearby pipe to extinguish the fire. After this, they observed what appeared to be human skull among the debris. As a result, the police were summoned. It was also brought to the attention of the ranks that Rodwell is mentally unstable and is known to the woman's family. Despite his mental condition, they said he does quality construction for the family and his fees are reasonable. A post-mortem report conducted on the remains by government pathologist Dr. Niyal Singh gave the cause of death as severe blunt trauma to the head. Further, it was also noted by Dr. Singh that the deceased was dead before the fire. Body samples were taken for DNA testing. The suspect was arrested by the police and is assisting with the investigations.
Taste, you will never decline. Extra lemon and lime, it's the two combined. It's one of a kind. Extra lemon and lime, extra lemon and lime. Taste the citrus in every sip.
It's here. Igloo ice cream fruit bars. Four mouth-watering flavors: mango, pineapple, strawberry, and soursop. A beautiful combination of real fruit and Igloo ice cream. Go old school with Flutie Popsicle. Classic flavors and refreshing goodness. Available at Igloo outlets and all your favorite shops.
I'm Anshul. I'm the manager over here at Brooklyn Institute of Vocational Training. We provide home health tech training here. For that, we have flexible classes, which includes morning, evening, and the weekend class. You can choose any class whichever is convenient for you. Also, this career is now at the peak. This career pay rate increases from 1909 till up to 2109 now. I speak different languages, which includes Hindi, Punjabi, Urdu, Bangla. And our certificate is recognized all over the New York because we are licensed from Board of Education. Once you graduated from our school, you can work with any agency anywhere in New York. Our address is 110-05 Liberty Avenue, Queens. Guys, I know the name is Brooklyn Institute, but we are located in Queens. I repeat the address, 110-05 Liberty Avenue, Queens. 11419 is our zip code, and my number is 929-386-0092. If you have any questions, you can always call me and I will be happy to answer all your questions. Don't forget to check our website www.mybrooklyninstitute.com. Come join our school and get home health aid certificate, as we like to believe changing lives one student at a time.
Guyana Fire Service was called into action just after 12 a.m. to put out a fire at the White Boys Auto Spares and Accessories located at lots 446, 447 Annandale East Coast, Demerara. The fire ripped through the bun of the popular spare parts store and left in its wake millions of dollars in damages. The two-storied concrete building is owned by 42-year-old Muhammad Ali, and its contents were destroyed. Ali was at a loss for words as he watched his years of investments burn to the ground. The Guyana Fire Service is reporting that the cause of the fire is unknown at this time, and fire prevention staff are conducting investigations.
With 70% ethyl alcohol, Mighty Foam Hand Sanitizer eliminates 99.99% of all germs and even moisturizes in the process, leaving your skin clean and hydrated. Mighty Foam Hand Sanitizer. How do you stay clean?
Washi. Hi, people. Washing made so easy since I found Washi. Washi me use, wash me clothes, and I can say, washi soap powder, wash clothes so nice. Washi soap powder, leave your clothes color bright. Washi soap powder, leave me clothes smelling nice, of course. So give thanks for washi soap powder for doing my laundry right. Keep my clothes color bright. Have me clothes smelling nice for sure. I could not ask for more. Comes in lemon and original. It is a washing machine in a pack. Wash your soap powder, wash clothes so nice. Wash your soap powder, leave your clothes color bright. Wash your soap powder, have my clothes smelling nice, of course.
Distributors located in the Starbrook Market.
Running late and can't wait at the gate? We got you. The Guyana Public Service Cooperative Credit Union Limited has introduced a fast and easier way to make payments to your accounts through the GT&T mobile money services. Here's how. Click on the MMG app, under Services, select Pay Bills. When you are there, look for the Financial Institution option. Once that is done, select Guyana Public Service Cooperative Credit Union Limited to pay your loan or make payments to your savings. Payments to the credit union made easier. GPSCCU, the credit union you can bank on.
A section of the Barta Castellan collapsed this afternoon, following heavy wind and rain. No one was injured. The Stellan was in a state of disrepair for years. The Stellan is expected to be rehabilitated at a cost of $553 million. The contract was awarded to K&K Construction and Hardware Supplies. For these and other stories, do visit us at our website www.rdproduction.com.